In this video, we're going to create a basic pivot table. So first, what is a pivot table? Well, a pivot table is a feature in Excel that lets you summarize large data sets, similar to this example that we have here. And it lets you summarize it in a way that'll be easier for you to conclude things from it and to be able to just really get different information from the data set. And you'll see what I mean in a minute. So first, we'll make sure everything is formatted correctly. So we have all of our columns have headings and all of the headings are together. What I mean by that is, let's say we have all of this information, columns A through G, and media cost is way over here. Well, that's not gonna work with pivot tables. If you have empty columns or empty column headers, you'll get an error and you just need to fix that. So we'll move, just drag that back over so that everything is together. And we'll wanna make sure that our cursor is just anywhere in the data set. So we go to the Insert tab and choose Pivot Table. And it automatically highlights what it perceives to be our data set. And for this exercise, this is correct. If you have a different data set, then obviously you would just adjust that where it says Table Range. And then we can also choose, do we want our pivot table in a new or an existing worksheet? For this exercise, it'll be easier in a new worksheet, so this is good, and we just hit OK. And you can see where the skeleton of our pivot table is now populated here in columns A through C. And then we also have our field settings, which include all of the headings from our data set. And then down at the bottom, we have boxes for filters, columns, rows, and values. So to get started on this example, let's say we want to know how many of each product was sold by year. So we want to choose year, and we'll put that here in the rows. And you'll see how 2015 and 2016 have populated in column A. Then we want to add the product, because that's what we want to see. And you see now we have blouses, boots, dress pants, etc. by year. And then we want to know how many were sold. So we choose quantity sold and we move that over to the values box. Now this values box is where the calculations happen. Notice how this automatically defaulted to sum. If I click on it, I can choose value field settings and I can choose a sum, count, average, max. They have several options to choose from, but for this exercise we just need to know the total quantity, so sum is perfect. But we do want to format it differently, so I'm going to choose number format to number, add a comma, and choose OK. And you see now we can see the quantity sold. It's a little bit cleaner, cleaner to read with the commas. And let's see, what else do we want to see? Maybe we also want to know how much we spent in media costs. What did our advertising cost us? So we can just drag media costs over to the same value setting, and we'll want to make that dollar. So number format again. Okay, and now we know in 2015 we spent about $307 million in media costs, and then you can see by product what that media cost broke out to be. So let's say we want to see what the media source was. Where did that dollars come from? Again, you just drag it down and now you can see by blouses in 2015 how much was sold via email and what did it cost for us to sell through the email marketing channel. But you know what? Now there's just a lot of information here. So let's move the year to the filter box. And you see how doing that caused this year field to move right above the pivot table information and it says all. In that dropdown, you can choose the year. And let's say we just want to look at 2015. So now the information in our pivot table is only for 2015. But maybe there's another way to look at this. Let's say we want products to be in our rows and we want to have columns be at the top, or we want to have media sources be at the columns. Well, we just dragged that over from rows to columns. And you can see how it changed the pivot table. So now we see quantity sold by media source, and then media cost by product. So we can say $4 million email for blouses and so on. And let's say, you know what, maybe we don't want all of that information. It's just as simple as grabbing what you don't want from here and moving it out. So let's take media cost out and we just see quantity sold. And because we have the media source at the top, we can now tell that we sold a grand total in 2015 of 165,000 blouses, but we can now see by media source how those sales happened. So pivot tables let you move your data headers around, move your data around, and summarize it in different ways so that you can get to whatever information you're trying to deduce from your data set. And so I hope you enjoyed this pivot table exercise and happy pivoting. And if you have not yet subscribed to this channel, please do so. We will be sharing additional videos very soon. Thanks. Bye-bye.